Gav, that was a special night, maybe all the more so because it didn't happen a year ago.
Yeah, we're quite overwhelmed, to be honest, with how it went. You know, you've seen everyone here together tonight and what a job it's been, and just it's a chance to celebrate, like you say, 2 years rather than one, which it's always been.
Yeah, and names that we're hearing tonight that I'm sure we'll be hearing a whole lot more about in the future.
Yeah, and without adding too much pressure on them all, it's a chance to, you know, reward them in a different way, and they've got the opportunity now to go forward and use that as a motivation for themselves and to try and, you know, not just earn trophies, but go and try and earn eventually a professional contract here. And, you know, having everyone here together from the first team all the way down to the where it begins, you know, with our scouting team and some of the pre-academy players, it's brilliant. It's the only time probably in the year that we get a good opportunity to do this.
There was a message from some of the academy graduates who've made it to top team. Well, it was quite amusing at the time as well. Dean Campbell and Conor McLennan, who needed about 12 rehearsals before they could actually get it right. Who else was involved? Andy Considine was in there, Calvin Ramsey, Jack McKenzie as well. There's a long list at the moment of players from the academy getting into the first team. And it's so important, isn't it, that that pathway is obvious to all these youngsters, the way ahead for them.
Yeah, that's right, Robert. You know, you look at those boys that you mentioned there, you know, with the exception of Andy, they all sat in this same awards night and they've worked their way back along the rows to eventually becoming a young professional. And every one of them's journey is going to be very different. Our job as an academy and football club is to give every individual what they need. Sometimes that's time, you know, sometimes that's an additional challenge. Sometimes it's technical attributes, sometimes it's mental attributes. But that's what we're here for. We're here to develop players, we're here to develop individuals, and hopefully they can go on and follow some of the successes of those players that you've just mentioned and play in the managers who was here tonight, as you know, in his first team, and go and take this club to really high places.
It's great for everyone to get that recognition tonight and that slap on the back, but I guess you're constantly looking to kick the academy on and develop it further and further, because standing still is the equivalent of going backwards.
No, I am, but it's got to be done with a team of people, and I know I'm, yes, you know, I want to drive this as much as we can, which is why I've been given the role, but you can't do it without the team of staff that are here tonight. And as I said earlier today, this evening, there's so many people we would have to thank that contribute to this. And the job that we do here and the job that the parents do, it's relentless. It really is. It doesn't stop. It just keeps going. And I think we're probably at a stage, this is why I was saying before, we're quite overwhelmed that this is coming to a close of 2021. It's been the biggest challenge probably for every football club has had to experience over the last 18 months. And how we've come through it, we have to take massive confidence from that, massive pride in how we've done it and how we've gone about our business. And I actually think we're going to come out of this whole pandemic stronger than we went in. I think when you look at the work that's gone on individually and as groups, and the challenges that we're now setting with young players and to try and stretch their development, I'm excited. And I know from the management team, the first team staff, they come and watch the games, they come out to training, they are as well. And a number of the first team now are getting involved in our training sessions quite regularly. So having us all together at Cormac Park, creating that wonderful environment, which I believe we have, I'll repeat myself again, it's about becoming the best developers of young Scottish talent this country has.
Well done, you and your staff. A fantastic job, and thanks very much.